hypothetically 0.5 milligrams or something. I still got it.
All right.
Who inspired that?
You dead.
Yeah.
The sun is gonna come out. Yeah. And it's over. they want to be out. Yes. And come out and not be entangled again. Yes. So that same yoke of bondage. Yes. Christ has made us free.
Yes.
I found out, Brother Bale, that the devil has a philosophy with us. If it worked one time, it'll work.
Amen. Did the Lord speak to anyone?
everyone in here tonight. Did the Spirit of God speak to you tonight? I believe with Father Shalom, that the Spirit of God spoke to all of us tonight. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise for the man of God. Be in obedience to the Spirit of God. Thank God for the obedience of the man of God as he has poured out his heart. So I would encourage you tomorrow night to bring someone. Use your influence. That means that now you will sway someone to change their plans and come to a place that's destined for them to come to hear a word from God. One word can change someone's destiny. Amen. So I would encourage you to use your influence. We want to thank God for this dynamic choir under the direction of the great woman of God, Prophetess Adrian Vivens. If y'all would just give the Lord about 5 more minutes. I wanted Pastor Tate to come, but I see he slipped up. Yeah, okay. I would say is the Lord has graced him to publish a book that's called A Rapture. And if you would go on Barnes & Noble, Amazon, it's found in, you can find it on Amazon or Barnes & Noble. Amen. And it's a book that is going to prepare us for the rapture. You know, sometimes we go by all of these people's literature that we don't even know. And God has blessed us with some gifted people right here.
Absolutely.
In our area that we know.
Yes.
And I promise you, if my Pastor Tate, release anything, it's going to be scripture founded.
Yes.
It's going to be founded on the scripture, on the word of God. So I would encourage you to not only support him in the endeavor that the Lord has released him to publish a book by the Spirit of God, but get the book and read it. I believe without a shadow of a doubt, he has broken down by the Spirit of God what to expect to prepare ourselves for the rapture. The second coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I read a book that Pastor Brown gave to me from Jesse DePlantis. And he went to heaven. The Lord sent an angel to get him in earth and take him to heaven. And he said the Lord brought him to heaven just to tell him, showed him some tremendous things in heaven. But he brought him to tell him one thing to go back and tell the people in the earth, that he's coming back. And Jesse said, when the Lord told him that, when God told him that, he said, but they already know. He said, the Lord said the same thing. Tell my people, I'm coming soon. Tell my people, Jesse, I'm coming soon. I know some of y'all that say it now, why did he take Jesse? I don't know. You need to ask him when you get there. He said, he told him, he said, Lord, they already know you're coming. He said, Jesse, you tell them I'm coming. In other words, how they are living and what they are doing, they don't believe I'm coming. We're living in some trying times. And we still living like the Lord ain't coming back. Bishop talked about coming out with a testimony to church. Judgment starts first in the household of faith. If the righteous is scarcely saved, where will the sinners and the ungodly be found? But Jesse said, told him, tell him I'm coming. I'm soon to come. Are we ready to go to meet the Lord? want to thank the Lord for some of the citizens from New Covenant Missionary Church made it down. Thank God for our precious gift. Amen. Bishop said he can't see no friendly faces. He's shown up to see y'all. Amen. Lord, we thank God that we embrace him with love every time God sent him this way. Amen. I believe if a shout of doubt, the best of who you are, you have never tapped into yet. Who God has made you to be that you haven't become, you have not tapped into the potential that's still lying dormant. Push your neighbor and I'll be ready to give it back over to Bishop. Push your neighbor and say, neighbor, yeah.
There's more to you
than meets your own eye. Amen. Come on, Bishop.
Praise the Lord again. Now, we're getting ready to turn out for the night. And I want everybody to go out for a testimony. Amen. God bless you. We look forward to seeing you on tomorrow night. Now, if the Lord has blessed you tonight, you are as saved as you say you are, then you ought to want somebody else to be blessed.
Yes.
So you need to invite somebody to come tomorrow night, and you need to go pick them up, go get them.
Yes.
Yes. Child, you need to catch a ride over there to New Jerusalem this week.
Yeah.
Don't you go get them. Yeah. Go out of your way, because Jesus went out of his way for all of us. And we're looking forward to the Lord doing greater things all this week. No secret what God can do, what he's done for others, he'll surely do for you. We thank God for all the members of the government who made it down the van, finally. It's all right this way. Tomorrow night, don't stay with me at the whole women's church. I just need you to tell two people God is. Say it like I said, man. Don't even talk about like you Methodist and all this stuff. Tell them God is who you are. You might not want him to be, but he is. I don't deserve it, but he is. I do want to thank God for First Lady Smith tonight. And bless the Lord because a lot of people don't know what First Ladies have to deal with.
Amen.
Because they never been married to a pastor. Let me tell y'all, a pastor ain't no joke.
Amen.
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 God prepared special women. Special women to take on that position because her whole job is to minister to the man of God.
Yeah.
That's her whole job. Anything else she does, God allows. But her job and her work is to minister, to soothe his wounds, and y'all beat him up, and talk about him, and disrespect him, and have his, him for lunch and dinner. All that kind of stuff. He goes home to her.
Yes.
And she makes it right.
Yes.
So he can come back and y'all can do it again. As always, happy to see Prophet Biz. Now I want to share one thing with you before I go. I'm very, very particular about the things of God that he's given me to do. And I do my darndest to follow according to the word of God and not the word of mouth. Because people and tradition will lead your own. But you got to follow the word of God to the letter. And the Holy Spirit will give you revelation as to the things of God. Amen. I grew up in the Baptist church and the things I learned weren't quite right. But they gave me the best they had. Some of them couldn't barely read. The pastor could hardly read, but that didn't grow to preach.
All right.
Amen. And
because I grew up believing that money was the root of all evil.
Come on now, come on.
Now that I'm, when Mr. Randall got saved, I know it's the root, the love of money.
Come on, come on.
Is the root of all evil. You live in that old time religion. You think money is the root of all evil, and you need to bring the bishop your evil. Put it in the name of America. I'm gonna hold it till God save you. God bless you. Let me be the wilderness. So thank you. I will give you pastors after my own heart. That's the word of God. God gives us that gift. And we ought to treat that gift like it's a gift from God.
Yes. Yes.
And it's the gift of God.
Yes.
Amen. Nothing you do with your pastor, God will reward you for.
Yes.
Little small thing. Go. When I took those coming down, I would do the revival. And he said, we're going to have a Pepsi Cola for you every night.
Amen.
I got hit a pain. I think he went to the plant and got that thing. I took one sip and some kind of tongue started coming out. And I want to let you know he's a man of his word. But listen, let me say this in seriousness. We're living a time now where pastors, good pastors, dedicated, loving pastors are walking away from their pulpits at alarming rates because they can't take the pressure. They can't take